Hi everyone, today's unboxing is for a book haul from bookoutlet.com. This is where you get discount books. Every week they have new stock that comes in. They get remainders from regular bookstores, so they're brand new books, but they're the brand new ones that the regular bookstores have not sold, and so they ship them new but unsold back to the publisher, and the publisher then sells them to places like bookoutlet.com, where they turn around and sell them at discount prices. So I get loads of books from bookoutlet.com. I am in so much trouble with them. I have to stop looking at their website because every week I go and look. Well, I try not to do it every week, but I somehow find myself getting on there and perusing and seeing such great deals that I like can't resist. I have no control. So this is my February 2023 haul. I ordered 21 books and I spent $80, and that averages out to be like $3.83 a book. It took 9 days to get to me. This one, if I remember correctly, is largely, I want to say largely cozy mysteries, but I won't know for sure till I get into them. Now, you can kind of tell by the mess I've got going here that I have opened them. Now, I haven't, except to like see the ones that I can see the crack on the top there, like this one, I can kind of see in the top there. I haven't looked in them. The reason that I opened them is because there are three boxes and I didn't want to torture your poor ears with opening the three boxes because it's quite loud, and I'm going to have to move the boxes anyway because there's not enough room for me to show you everything. So, but I wanted to show you here, you know, here they are. Here's my three boxes. So let me move these out of the way and then really dive into them and see what we've got. Oops, that one kind of ripped already. Okay. So let's start with this one. All right, this one I can actually open up because, oh my gosh. Okay. This is funny, people. That is the only book in that box. Oh my gosh. Okay, you know, when you spend $35 or more at Book Outlet, which I inevitably do, you get free shipping. So I guess it doesn't really matter to them. But I'm really thinking that's probably not the wisest way to spend their money, to ship one book in this kind of box. I don't know. Could they not fit it in one of the other boxes? That's just weird. Okay, so let me pull it out and we'll toss this box aside. All right, so the first one I have, this is a cozy mystery. This is a Cat in the Stacks mystery. This is file M for murder. We don't typically have stickers on them. That's kind of weird. Oh, it comes off, well, rather easy. This is by Miranda James. And another one. Yeah, this is kind of weird because we don't usually get a bunch of stickers on them. Oh, this one, no, I guess that's okay. All right, here's the remainder mark showing you that it, you know, was in a, it's new, but it was in a new bookstore at one point in time. I am actually kind of collecting the ones from this series before I start reading them. Okay, so this one is a Cat in the Stacks mystery, and it is copyrighted 2012. So there we go. Okay, and then the other small box I got, let's open this one up. Oh my gosh, you're not gonna believe this. Oh, there's two in it this time. Okay, two books in this box. People, this is insane. This is just insane. Okay, let me take the two of them out. I hope the other box is fuller than this. Sorry for the noise there. Okay, so the first one I have is a One for the Books by Jen McKinley. It did get a little bit, I got a little like rip here. This is from a Library Lovers mystery series. Yeah, this one got bounced around a little bit. No wonder, considering it was only one of two books in a huge box. Okay, and this is another one where I'm kind of trying to accumulate all the books in the series. Okay, so this one is copyrighted 2020. Okay, and then this one I just thought looked cute. An Eggnog to Die For, Amy Pershing. This is Cape Cod Foodie Mystery. And this just sounded cool. These currently are, oh, that one got bumped a little too. Can't imagine why. okay, and then this one is a 2021 release. And as you can see, so far, all cozy mysteries. Okay, so then let's get to the bigger box. The bigger box I'm going to kind of show you just a little bit, and then I'll take it back out. You can see this one is more full up. Although I think they could have at least fit two of those books in there. That's just weird. Just weird. Okay. So the next book that I have is Dying in a Winter Wonderland by Vicki Delaney. This is from A Year-Round Christmas Mystery. In one of my previous book outlet hauls, I did get, I think, two others from this series. Again, a little bit bumped up, but I'm not complaining. I'm not complaining. I'm really just pointing it out. This is a 2020 cozy mystery. And then I have A Side of Murder. This is in this series, the Cape Cod Foodie Mystery. This is by Amy Pershing. And another cozy mystery. I've been kind of getting into the cozies recently. This is a 2021 release. Okay. And then I have, well, I guess I'm going to kind of try and stick with the cozies for right now. I got quite a few of them. Like I said, I thought this was my cozy box. Here is The Silence of the Library by Miranda James. This is a Cat in the Stacks mystery, which is goes along with that one. Oh, this one got cut. Look at that. That was not me opening the box, by the way, because the box I just had to rip open. I did not take any scissors to it. Oh, that's a bummer. Well, thankfully, it's not really into... guess I'll have to tape that. It's not really into the book itself. That's a bummer. Hope I didn't pay too much for that one. 2014. So that's a 2014. All right. Then I have a Glory Falls by Janine Roche. This is a Madison River romance. This is a Christian romance, if I remember correctly. Yeah, inspirational romance. I know of Janine, but I have not read anything by her. So when I saw her, I think I got another one in there by her. When I saw the books by her, I was like, I'm going to have to try that. Okay. And then I have another Cat in the Stacks mystery, Classified as Murder by Miranda James. I have to keep a close eye on it when I'm doing these buyings like this. This is a 2011 release. I keep a list of all the books that I've got on my shelves for the purposes of making sure I don't buy duplicates, because I don't know if you can relate, but I buy so many books and I'm always buying books that I inevitably will buy something that I forgot I had on my shelves. So I try not to do that, especially when it's a point like this where I actually have the time, I can go and look to see if I already got that. So then I have Murder in the Margins, which is from an open book mystery series. This one says it's the first in a new series by Margaret Loudon. I'm drawn to the one with the animals, the cozies with the animals on them, 2020. I don't know why. Maybe they're more cozy. I don't know. Okay. Then I have Checking Out Crime, a Bookmobile Cat Mystery by Lori Cass. Pretty much when you mention bookstores, cats, dogs. I'm like there. I'm there. Okay, this is a 2021. So some of these are older, some of these are not. All right. And then I have The Broken Spine by Dorothy St. James, which is a beloved book room mystery. I believe I have another one on my shelf from this series. Okay, and that's a 2021. All right. And then I have another one by Janine Roche. This is a Whisper Canyon romance, so a different series. Inspirational romance, Aspen Crossroads. And this one is a 2021 release. Okay. And then, what else do I got here? I'm kind of sifting through a little bit because I'm trying to get all the cozies. Since there's so many of them. Okay. So then I have this one, a Handbook for Homicide, which is a Booktown mystery by Lorna Barrett. I actually have something from this series already on my shelf. And there's quite a few in the backlist, so. Okay, and this one is a 2020 release. Gonna have to start stacking. Okay, and then this one, For Badder or Worse, by Jen McKinley. This is a Cupcake Baker mystery. Jen McKinley, I got one of her books from this series already from one of my book boxes, and I also have been picking up the ones in her book series, so I actually got to get around to reading them rather than collecting them. This is a 2021 release. Okay, and then this one is The Bookshop of Second Chances by Jackie Fraser, and okay, they had me a bookshop. I mean, the moment I saw that, I'm like, that looks so interesting. What is that one about? This one, if I remember correctly, is a romance. Yeah, I believe this one's a romance. But I actually, now, let me just check to see what the date is on this one. This is a 2020 publication, but the mass market is a 2022 release, so it like got repackaged. But I don't buy the books just because I like the covers or the titles, although that did catch my attention right away. But I was very intrigued when I read the synopsis on that one. So okay, so then I have, this is another cozy mystery. This is A City of Schemes, which is a counterfeit lady novel. This by Victoria Thompson. This one is a historical cozy. And I have been seeing hers on Book Outlet, and they haven't been priced well enough for me to want to get them yet. Because you can see here, I mean, there's quite a backlist there. This is a 2020 release. But when I saw this one, like I said, I've been kind of eyeing them. And when I saw that one, I'm like, okay, well, I'm going to get that one. Okay. And this is when you don't check things out properly. Sometimes I will click to add in the cart and forget that I already had them in the cart. And usually I check to make sure I don't have two sitting there, but apparently I got two sitting there. So, all right then, somebody's going to be getting a copy. Okay. Okay. And then you just come across things. So like the majority of this haul was cozy mysteries. But I came across a few other things that I just had to pick up while I was in there. And this is one of them. This is Star Wars Resistance Reborn by Rebecca Roanhorse. And this is like Rogue One. If you've seen the movie Rogue One, this is one of the Star Wars books from that particular line. And this one is for my husband, actually, because he doesn't read a whole lot, but he has been kind of reading some of the Star Wars books. He's a little bit picky about it, but I know that he likes Rogue One, and that one was such a great price. I just had to pick it up. Okay, then I have this trade paperback, Bringing Down the Duke by Evie Dunmore, which this is from A League of Extraordinary Women. I just love the covers on these. That immediately grabbed my attention, and I was like, that looks like a fun historical. This is from 1879. This is a historical romance. I am not sure if it's clean. It's a 2019 release. And I liked the synopsis of it, but I can't say for sure if it's clean reads. And I prefer my books to be clean reads. So I'm really, really hoping, really, really hoping that that is. So I guess we'll just have to see. Okay. Then I have Because I Could Not Stop for Death by Amanda Flower. This is an Emily Dickinson mystery. So this is another trade paperback. This is a historical mystery from 1855. When is this one published? I feel like this is a newer release. 2022. Yeah, this is 2022. Amanda Flower actually writes a lot of Amish cozy mysteries. So when I saw she had a trade paperback and it was a historical, I thought I got it. You know, I got to check that one out. Okay, and along with historical mysteries, I got another one from Anna Lee Huber. This is Mortal Arts, and this is a Lady Darby mystery. And I have been trying to get this whole series before I start reading it. She wrote The Anatomist's Wife. That was the first one. Scotland, 1830. So this is not her latest. No. 2013. But this is one of those ones where it was not available on Book Outlet when I got several others by her. So this is an older release that showed up and I was like, I got to get that one. Like I said, I'm big on getting series together, especially when it comes to things like this. Not so much with the cozies, although I am trying, you can see I'm trying to get some of the series, but, it's not, you don't, they're, how do I put this? They're not, you don't have to worry about reading cozies out of order much of the time. So I don't worry about that over much with that. But I do like with things like this, we are, well, you follow the same, I don't know. For some reason, it's the trades seem to be a little bit more like, I want to read everything in order. I don't know. Do you guys think I'm weird for that kind of stuff? I don't know. Okay, then the last book that I have in this haul has nothing to do with cozies, with romance, none of it. But I had stuck, this is my little story. I stuck it in my cart when I first saw it a few months ago. And I was super excited about it because it was on my Amazon wish list and I had been wanting it, but I was waiting for a better price on it. And I saw it at Book Outlet. I was like, cool, I got it. And I stuck it in there. Now, it got shipped to me, but that box was lost in the mail. So when I contacted Book Outlet, I'm like, where's this box at? They said, we are so sorry. That got lost in the mail. We will send you a new box. But when they did that, they're like, we're out of stock with that particular book. So we're sorry we can't send you that one. I was so bummed. So when it showed up again, I'm like, oh my gosh, it's here. I have to get it. I hope the box comes. And it did. This is it here. It's one of those days by the DeVeers, husband and wife artists. This is a comic book. It's a comic book. I love comic books. I have ever since I was a kid. I used to collect like Archie Comic Digests and Richie Rich Comic Digests, and that kind of morphed into other comics. I'm not real big on the like superhero comics or the thin paper ones. Like the Comic Digest, the Archie ones, those are a little bit, they got a little bit of heavier, they're paperbacks, but they still have a little bit of a heavier cover to them. So anyhow, I'm digressing. I like comics. I came across this couple and they reminded me in a lot of respects. I mean, some of the things they talk about with parenthood and stuff is things I can absolutely relate to, but also things as a couple they would do. They do drawings of themselves and their family. And there were things that I was sharing with my daughter. I'm like, you've got to see this artist because this reminds me of you and your husband. And my daughter's like, I already know about them, Mom. I told you about them already. Anyhow, long story. I know. I apologize. Anyway, this is their hardcover. See their family. So I had to get it. Look how thick it is. So So this is cool because it's got like the drawings and then it's got the colored, the finished ones. And it's when they get together and when they have their children. They are kind of, I wouldn't say they're not, I wouldn't say it's not clean because it's just they're kind of on the edge there with some of the drawings, as you probably saw when I was flipping through it. So, gosh, I'm not sure how much I would rate it. I don't think it's inappropriate. I just think that there's, in some respects, a little more skin than you might want to see. So, anyhow, I was just super excited to get this within that haul because I cannot tell you, can't remember what the price was I paid for it, but I paid way less than I had it on my Amazon account for. So I was really excited about that, and it got to me. All right. So, wow. And I have to cover up things because there's so many. Okay, so that is everything that I got in my February 2023 Book Outlet book haul. If you like this video, please take a moment to hit the like button down below. And also, if you subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell to let me know, it'll let you know when I post my unboxings. And as always, I love your comments. What did you think of this haul? Were there any books in particular that you were excited about? You can actually probably find some of them still on the website. Some of them may be gone by now. You know, you kind of take your chances. But I warn you, it can be very addicting. So, or if you just want to say hi, that's okay too. I love your comments. I read and respond to them all. You know, if you, I do a lot of these because I love this website so much. And I keep showing everybody because I've had a few of you say, yes, we want you to keep doing this. So, you know, if that's the case, if you're, I mean, if you're getting tired of them, just say, yeah, I think we're tapped out. You know, don't bother doing anymore. But if you want me to continue sharing when I'm doing these hauls, I will be happy to do so. I love sharing my love of books with everybody. So that is going to be it for today's video. Thanks so much for stopping by and watching. You guys are awesome, as always. Have a great day.